We've been taught lies in our churches. We've been taught lies in our schools.
Right.
We're here to bring out the truth today.
That's
we're
right.
going to show you what the truth is according to the Bible.
Right.
And the truth is what's going to set us free as well. Give me what you got.
Psalms, chapter 119, verse 142.
Bring it out.
Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness.
Because we're not out here teaching hate. We're not out here teaching to harm anyone. We're out here to teach righteousness. What righteousness is according to the Bible.
Right.
And we're also here to teach the truth. Read.
And thy law is the truth.
You don't know what Christ looked like.
So the law is the truth. So let's also talk about another biblical truth of today. Let's talk about Jesus the Christ, who everyone says they follow, but somehow don't know what he looks like. All right, let's bring out the book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 1.
Bring it out!
Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1.
Bring it out!
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
It says the revelation of Jesus Christ. The root word of revelation means reveal. So, we're going to reveal what Jesus Christ actually looked like. Read.
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
Because God even knew at some point his son, who would die on the cross for the nation of Israel, would have his identity replaced by an impostor. So he told the prophets to write down record of what Christ would actually look like today. Read Revelation 1 and 14.
Revelation chapter 1 verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
It said the hair on his head was white like wool. How you doing today, sister? What's your name?
Lisa.
Lisa? Nice to meet you, Lisa. My name's Kazaniah. But the Bible was saying his head and his hairs were white like wool. Do you know who wrote the book of Revelations? The prophet John. John was one of the disciples. Unlike a lot of you so-called Christians out there, they say they have a personal relationship. This guy actually has a personal relationship with Jesus Christ.
Right,
now let's
right.
see how John describes Christ. The first thing he said, he had woolly hair. Now who in the nation, who on the face of the earth has woolly hair as a people?
Look it up.
Let's look at a side-by-side comparison of these two images, right? Now the man on the left here, right, with all these different images, that's the actual man that walked on the face of the earth. His name is Caesar Borgia. Not Jesus the Christ, but he was a pedophile. He was the son of Pope Alexander III. This is not a good man that we think is Jesus Christ today. Now let's get back to the scriptures. Read.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So, Jesus the Christ, his head and his hairs were white like wool. Now Lisa, as you go up in age, what happens to our hair? It turns white. But does the texture ever change? So if you have woolly hair, and I have woolly hair, and we so-called African Americans, what does that say about Christ? Let's keep reading.
As white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So one of Jesus Christ's first miracles is turning water into wine. Alright? When we drink wine, our eyes be red. Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Now Lisa, look down at your feet. Is your feet the same color as the rest of your body? So John is writing down the complexion of Christ's feet. Then surely he's talking about the rest of the complexion of his entire body.
Right.
Now it said his feet is like unto fine brass. What is the color of fine brass? You ever heard of bronze? Okay, so brass or polished brass or fine brass is all derivatives of brown.
Right.
Now let's see what complexion of brown Jesus Christ was. Read.
As if they burn in the furnace.
So Lisa, if you take some toast and you put it in the furnace or an oven and you leave it in there too long, what color is it going to be? It's going to be black. It's going to be dark black. That said, Jesus Christ, his feet like unto fine brass, as if it what?
As if they burn in the furnace.
Now how could you get a white man out of that? So my question to you is, why do we watch movies with Mel Gibson portraying himself as Christ? Well, it's the same reason you watch all these other movies where black people are portrayed as white people all of a sudden. Now, let's see what the Bible says. Because guess what? They didn't only change his image. They changed his doctrine. And they changed his mission. Now, first we're going to get John 7:38. Let's see if we're supposed to believe on Christ as the scriptures say, or just believe blindly because he's all people, all colors, all races, or some people even say he's a spirit, or he never even walked the earth, but nobody knows what he looks like. But let's see what the Bible says. Let's see if the Bible says it matters if Christ is a black man or not. Let's see if black lives really matter. Read.
John chapter 7, verse 38. He that believeth on me.
It says, he that believeth on me. Meaning everybody's not going to believe on Christ the way that Christ is.
Right.
Read.
As the scripture have said.
Because everybody's not going to go and justify their words according to the scriptures. So we must justify our words and come out of the Bible and show you that Christ is a black man. That's according to the scriptures. Not because of our personal preference. Right? Read that again from the top.
John chapter 7, verse 38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said,
as the scripture has said, read,
out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
That rivers of living water is symbolic to the true understanding of the nature and the what Christ actually stood for. Now, we understand the mission of Christ. Let me ask you a question. Who did Jesus Christ come here for? Yes, he came on earth. Who was he for? Who was he sent for? Because today we don't worship Jesus Christ the way that we're supposed to. I'm saying we as a people, not us in purple and gold, because guess what? We are the true Christians before you.
Right.
But the thing is, us as a people, we have not been taught the true understanding of Jesus Christ.
Right.
We haven't been taught his image. We haven't been taught his mission. We haven't been taught the doctrine. Read that.
2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus.
Because you just found out that Jesus looked like you. Jesus looks like the brother behind you. Jesus looks like all these men up here. But that's not the one you see on TV. That's not the one you see on your grandmother's wall. That's not the one you see on the crosses all over the world. That's not the one that's recognized in all the countries internationally. But the Bible says that he's a black man. Right? Let's see what the Bible says now. Read.
Whom we have not preached.
Read it from the top.
For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus.
Because you gotta think, when did they come and teach another Jesus? Our ancestors knew nothing about a white man called Caesar Borgia.
Right.
That was something that was beat into us. We were burned at the stakes if we did not worship. Here it is right here. Now check this out, Lisa. It says, he that cometh and teacheth another Jesus. What happened to our ancestors when we got up from slave ships? We were forced to serve a white Jesus. We were forced into religions like Catholicism.
Right.
We were forced into Christianity. We were forced into things like Islam. We were forced to serve other gods.
Right.
But the Bible says, if he cometh that teacheth another Jesus, read,
whom we have not preached.
Whom we have not preached. None of the prophets ever spoke anything about a white man, because all the prophets are black men themselves.
Right.
Right.
Read.
Or if he receive another spirit.
Another spirit is coming into another doctrine. When we come out here and teach according to the Bible, the way that the Bible demands us to teach, a lot of people have a problem with that because we speak as men. You don't go in Sunday school, Sunday church, and see men speaking like men. They're speaking soft, weak, and effeminate like your Joel Osteens, like your Creflo Old Dollars, like your T.D. Snakes.
Get out!
Right.
They're not teaching in the right spirit.
Right.
So now they got a false Jesus. They got a false spirit. What else?
Which ye have not received.
Which we did not get from our forefathers like Moses. Which we did not get from our forefathers like David. Because they were strong, powerful, mighty men.
Right.
Read.
Or another gospel.
Or what?
Or another gospel.
Or what?
Or another gospel.
So another gospel has been taught in this earth.
Right,
guess
right.
What? The gospel that the so-called blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans follow today is the Antichrist doctrine.
Right.
The Antichrist doctrine is just Sunday church. The Antichrist doctrine is Catholic. The Antichrist doctrine is Baptist. The Antichrist doctrine is Pentecostal. The Antichrist doctrine is non-denominational. The Antichrist doctrine teaches you you do not have to keep the laws of God. The Antichrist doctrine teaches you that Jesus Christ is a white man and not a black man. The Antichrist doctrine is teaching you that God came for every single person on this earth and not the children of Israel.
Right.
Right.
So let's keep reading.
Read.
Which ye have not accepted, ye might well bear with him.
Because they taught all these different doctrines and we didn't have our minds right, we went with them. That's why we populate the churches today. Now that you know that Jesus Christ, his image has been changed and his doctrine has been changed, let's hear from Christ himself who he actually came for. Matthew 15:24. Because these are the things that we don't go over in our churches. We as a people, we say we love God, but we don't know God. We don't know Christ, his son. We don't even know what he came here for. We don't even know who we are. Hey, my sisters, I pray that y'all listen as y'all walk down the street, because some heavy knowledge is about to come out that you're not going to hear tomorrow. Read.
Matthew 15:24.
Uh-huh.
But he answered and said.
He said, but he answered and said, this is red letter, sister. This is the words of Christ. This is his reply. Read.
I am not sent.
He said, I am not sent. What?
But unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
He said, I am not sent, but only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Right.
Let's see if God changes. Let's go in Amos 3:1.
Let's see if
that's something new. Because guess what? That's in the New Testament right there. We just read out of Matthew. All right? So these are actual words that the prophets wrote down according to what Christ was saying. But let's see if God established what Christ did before Christ even hit the scene. Amos 3:1.
Amos 3:1.
Get up!
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you.
The Bible said, hear this word which the Lord has spoken against you. Who is the subject matter? Read.
O children of Israel.
They did not mention nobody else outside of this sign.
Right.
While I'm speaking, I want you to come over here, avert your eyes, and look and try to find yourself on this sign. Guess what? Even if you can't find yourself, at the very bottom, it tells you that we scattered throughout the four corners.
Right.
There is a great multitude of our people scattered in countries that is not on that list. But if you do see your forefathers on that list, guess what? You are the children that Christ has came back to redeem.
Right. Right.
Nobody needs a savior more than the children of Israel.
Right.
Read what you got.
Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt.
Because these are the children that came out of the land of Egypt with Moses through the wilderness. He delivered them once. He's going to do it again. Read.
Saying, you only.
He said, you only have I known. When Christ came on the scene, he said, I'm not only sent, but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So again, God is saying, what?
You only.
You only. Lisa. Read again.
You only,
children of Israel. Read.
Have I known
out of who?
Of all the families of the earth.
Out of everybody else on the earth, you only. What does that mean? Does that mean everybody on the same playing field? If it's a whole 1,000 people out here, and I say, Lisa, you only have I known, am I talking to the people behind you? Am I talking to the people in front of you? Am I talking to the people right of you? Guess what? You got more people with more money than you out here. You got more people that may have more things than you out here. But I just said you only because I chose you. That's how God is dealing with the nation of Israel.
Right,
let's
right.
Travel a little bit further back to the book of Deuteronomy and see if he says the same thing. And then we can travel all the way to the front, all the way to the last book of the Bible and show you the exact same thing. Lisa, you've been lied to. There's a common trend in the Bible. The trend is, God chose the Israelites.
Right.
We are those Israelites.
Right.
And I will show you your history according to the Bible as you understand it. I'm not going to teach no religion. I'm not even going to teach my own thing. I'm going to teach you. I'm going to show you in this book, a book that they say is a fairy tale, a book that they say is a white man's book. I'm going to show you your history. I'm going to show you your present, and I'm going to show you your future. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy 7:6.
Uh-huh.
For thou art a holy people.
So God said, thou art a holy people. He said, you see these people on the sign? We weren't made to be slaves. Those people on the sign were not made to live on Section 8. Those people on those signs was not made to be drug dealers, gang members. Those people was not made to be thoughts of baby mamas. They were made to be a holy people. The word holy means separate, set apart, clean, sanctified. Read what you got. Yeah, give me that.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 26. And ye shall be holy unto me.
So this is God's definition of holy. Because you might have a lot of Christians that say, oh yeah, I'm holy. But let's see if they really holy. Read what you got.
For I, the Lord, am holy, and has severed you from other people.
What does that mean? To be holy means to be severed. What do you do when you sever something? What's that? No, when you sever something. You know how you separate something? Sever it. You know what I'm saying? Read it again.
And ye shall be holy unto me.
So God is going to tell us what the definition of holy is. Right?
Read. For I, the Lord, am holy. And have severed you from other people.
Meaning he has set you apart from other people. You got a favorite pair of shoes, Lisa? You say yes? Do you have a favorite pair of shoes? Not really. Well, let's say you just had some shoes that one of your family members bought for you, and it's very special. It's priceless, right? Now you gonna take those pair of shoes, you gonna put them in a box, right? You gonna put them on the top shelf, right? Separate from all the other shoes. Guess what? We are those pair of shoes to the Most High.
That's right.
We are those shoes that he don't want not a stain or blemish on when he come back to come wear them now.
Right.
We are the shoes that if we get messed up and dirty, he gonna take some extra time to clean us up.
Right.
You understand? Now, we are God's favorite. We are God's chosen. Alright? But we in all manners of filth today. So we gotta clean ourselves up because Christ is coming back. I don't know if you've been watching the news, but this ain't the time to be messing around. This ain't the time to be guessing. Today is your day, alright?
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.